Surely everyone noticed that behind the famous Soviet T-34 tank there are mysterious oblong cylinders. Many people mistake them for extra fuel tanks. Is this really so, or is there something else in the cylinders? With this simple design element, not everything is so simple. Don't feel sorry for the machines. The hard workers are still setting up. This is exactly what the attitude of the Soviet command during the years of World War II to subordinates and entrusted resources, including military equipment, looks like. At least a considerable part of the inhabitants believe in this. Soviet industry really riveted combat vehicles by the thousands. However, this says something completely different. Although the T-34 tanks were sharpened specifically for mass production, the command and the country as a whole were of course interested in keeping military vehicles in service, since in a war the most important resources are not steel and oil at all, but time and people. Precisely to save lives and personnel and the T-34, they put intricate cylinders. Many fellow citizens mistake them for fuel tanks. In fact, this is a combat smoke bomb, KBDSH-5. KBDSH-5 was used to establish a smoke screen. It could be applied in a number of situations. For example, if a tank was hit, then its crew had the right to put up a curtain for further retreat or survival. In addition, smoke screens were used to distract the enemy during maneuvers or to shelter the advancing Soviet infantry. It is noteworthy that the tank smoke bomb was actually a slightly modified naval smoke bomb, which was installed on ships and boats even before the start of the war. BSHD worked from 5 to 7 minutes, creating a curtain with an area of up to 2 hectares. The Chekhovs were refueled with an anthracene smoke mixture. As a rule, the system was powered by an electric fuse. There were also mechanical and chemical options, but they were more expensive and, oddly enough, less reliable. Shoulder